Ladies and gentlemen, and the students of business, if you guys use Instagram, you must definitely would have heard of this brand named Adil Qadri, which is in the business of selling others, perfumes and other fragrances. And even if not, you must have seen their pitch in Shark Tank India Season 3, wherein the founder himself, Mr. Adil Qadri, came and pitched their brand. Now this brand, ladies and gentlemen, is building something very incredible. The brand Adil Qadri, which is actually named after the founder himself, who also goes by the name Adil Qadri, is actually a class 5th dropout. That means that this guy has not actually taken up any formal education or degree and has also not been to any of the premier business schools. Yet this brand, this guy Adil Qadri, has built his brand in such a manner that today this is one of the industry leaders in the other segment of India. Further, this brand is close to earning the average revenue run rate of up to 100 crores. This is pretty fascinating, right? A guy who actually dropped out of class 5th building a 100 crore brand. The thing is, there are some very powerful business lessons that we guys can learn from Adil Qadri's journey of him building his brand, and this is exactly what we are going to cover in today's business case study. So if you are planning to build your own brand or your own startup, or if you are a business student, this business case study of Adil Qadri's journey is going to be extremely valuable for you. There are some very incredible insights and some very powerful business lessons that we are going to cover based on his journey. Lesson number one: business opportunity. Whenever we plan on building a startup in today's world, whenever we plan on building something of our own in today's dynamics, we always look out for a problem which is yet unsolved. We always look out for a product or a service which actually does not exist in today's market and which the people of India or the people of the world will actually need, will actually demand for. The thing is, in today's dynamics, when entrepreneurs start building something of their own, when they start working on a business idea, they always go out for something which actually does not exist in today's world. But ladies and gentlemen, that is only one way to look out for a business opportunity. The alternative way is basically to look out for something which already exists in today's market, which used to exist in the past, and that has been vanished over the years. And if you guys can revive out that thing, if you guys can revive out that business, if you can revive out that product or service based on tech, based on your website or your application or your business model, that can actually be a very great business opportunity. Let me explain this to you with another very major example. Mahendra Singh Dhoni actually invested in a fitness startup in India, which goes by the name Tagda Raho. If you actually analyze the business model of Tagda Raho, you'll be extremely amazed. This startup Tagda Raho is basically in the business of desi fitness, traditional fitness of India. If you closely analyze the fitness industry of India in the traditional times as well as in the modern times, you'll notice that India used to have its own fitness techniques, own fitness programs. You guys must have heard of these names, which goes by Akhada, which goes by Mudgar. So these are some very traditional fitness equipments, traditional fitness techniques that India used to follow in the traditional times. Now with all these upcoming gyms, upcoming yoga sessions, upcoming fitness applications, the traditional business of India, the traditional fitness equipments of India, the traditional fitness regimes of India actually vanished. And Tagda Raho is actually reviving this entire traditional fitness industry by building on that exact problem. So the thing is, in order to look out for a business opportunity to start up your own startup, you always need not go out of a problem which is yet unsolved. You always need not go out of a product or a service which actually does not exist yet. In fact, there is another alternative way to go, which is to look at what the products or the services our ancestors used to use in the traditional times and to revive out those products and services again in today's modern world. And this startup that we're talking about today, which is Adil Qadri, the fragrance brand, the Atar brand, is actually also doing the exact same thing. Atar specifically are kind of fragrances that our ancestors used to use in the traditional times. But over a period of time, when this entire market got dominated by fragrances, perfumes, deodorants, the entire market of Atar actually vanished. And Adil Qadri is reviving out this market by by building on this major scale, by building on this idea of reviving Atar and being the king of this market again. And this is the reason why, if you actually look closely in India currently, there are hardly any D2C brands which operate in the segment of Atar. And this is the reason why Adil Qadri currently dominates this entire Atar segment in India and actually abroad as well, as they have started their exports. They have actually went global by opening their outlet in Dubai as well. This is a great business lesson to learn from Adil Qadri's journey, that you guys are not always supposed to look out for a business opportunity based on the future trends, but you can also look out for the business opportunity by checking on the past trends, the kinds of goods and services that people used to use in the traditional times, and reviving those products and services again with your own startup. The second business lesson that we guys can learn from Adil Qadri's journey is basically content marketing. I have said this in multiple of my business case studies, that if you guys plan on building a startup in today's world, you have to use the power of social media, you have to leverage the power of social media to build out that brand. And Adil Qadri is doing exactly the same thing. As he mentioned in the pitch of Shark Tank India Season 3, Adil Qadri uses the power of content marketing, the power of social media to a great extent. In fact, he makes multiple videos on his own to promote his brand, to promote his fragrances. And in those videos, if you closely analyze, he tries to convey a very powerful message. He tries to convey the ingredients, the usability, the use case of his fragrances across different dimensions and categories. So the thing is, when any entrepreneur, when any startup uses the power of social media, uses the power of content, they basically build a community around that content. By making that content, they basically build a community of potential buyers. And when the startup, when the product or service finally reaches the market, finally reaches the right audience, these people, these startups actually have potential buyers available without spending anything on marketing or advertising. So the thing is, if you guys are building a product or a service or a brand of your own, the first thing that you need to do is make content around that brand, around that product or service, so that you can make a community of potential buyers across your product or a service. And when the right time comes, when you actually launch your product or service in the market, you already have a major community of potential buyers to actually buy out your product, which will ultimately reduce your CAC, which is the cost of customer acquisition, which will actually reduce your marketing and advertising spends, and ultimately your brand can go for a pilot run. Your brand can go for a potential pilot run, potential test run, by selling out your products or services to your own community, which you built out of content marketing on social media. Lesson number 3, the power of personal branding. If you closely notice, in all the videos that Adil Qadri promotes and the kind of advertisements that Adil Qadri runs on social media, you'll notice that in all of his advertisements, the founder himself is the face of the company. Now, this is a very powerful lesson to go by. I'll explain this to you with a very simple example. I recently discovered that Ashneer Grover, when launched his third startup, Crickpay, which is into the fantasy gaming category, he had zero marketing budget. He did not spend anything on acquiring customers. Why? Because at that point of time, Mr. Ashneer Grover already had millions of followers on social media. He had an incredible reach on his Instagram account, and he simply put out a message. He simply put out a reel and a story stating that I am launching my third startup with the name Crickpay. And because of his community, because of his personal branding, he already had a large number of customers testing out his product, testing out his new startup. The same thing goes with Lenskart as well. You guys must have noticed that Lenskart also nowadays is doing all of its advertisements wherein the founder and CEO himself, that is Piyush Bansal, is coming out and promoting his own brand. The thing is, power of personal branding is an incredible thing to go by, which entrepreneurs and startups should leverage, should use. If you make a personal brand out of yourself, you can use that personal brand to build a product or a service or a brand around that. In fact, you will notice that all of the YouTubers that we see around nowadays are doing exactly the same thing. They are using their power of personal branding to build out another brand, to build out another product or service, and scale it rapidly. So as startup, as a young young entrepreneur, as someone who is building out a brand or a product or a service, you must leverage the power of your own personal brand to build out your own brand. Now, these three lessons that I just mentioned about Adil Qadri were actually on a positive side, right? Now, let us also consider some of the negative aspects of Adil Qadri's journey that we can learn from and actually apply in our own journey. Lesson number one, avoid debt in the initial phases. So Adil Qadri, this guy has actually raised a debt of 6 crores and this is creating problem for the startup because this company Adil Qadri is actually going under a vicious cycle of debt wherein to pay the existing debt, to meet the existing financial commitments, existing repayment obligations, this founder Adil Qadri has to raise another round of debt to pay off its existing vendors, to pay off its existing debt commitments. So if you guys are building out a startup, if you guys are building out a brand, you know, in the initial days of building a startup, you guys must not raise debt by any chance because it ultimately creates a major repayment obligations on you guys. And because in the initial phases of startup, we are never sure about the earnings, we are never sure about the demand, we are never sure about the business cycles of the brand, and if we raise debt by any chance, then there is a major possibility that our brand will kind of default on the debt and ultimately the brand goes bankrupt. And this is something that we have seen a lot of times in a number of industries such as editing. Lesson number two, the problem of scale. You guys must have noticed in Adil Qadri's pitch that the company nowadays is incurring huge amount of losses in spite of the fact that the company is earning a gross margin of 70%. And why is that? This is because the company is focusing massively on its scale. The company is doing influencer marketing, content marketing, running paid advertisements, going for offline stores, going towards an omni-channel business model. And the thing is, due to all of it, due to this massive scale, the company is incurring losses. But let me ask you guys a simple question. If a company is bootstrapped, if a company is using the funds that the company generates out of its profits, retaining back those funds and building the company again in the next year, what is the point of going 10x scale in the initial phases? Why do you need to do that? The simple thing is, if you guys are running a bootstrap startup, it can be done simply the way the traditional companies used to do in India. That means that you can simply look out for a scale of 2x, 3x or 5x. Because if you guys scale up to 10x or 20x of your existing financials, you guys would always have to burn incredible amount of money. And that is exactly what Adil Qadri is doing. And because of this, the company eventually loses money and runs out of cash. And again, this is the same thing that is being faced by this company as well, that the company is running out of runway. For those startups which actually raise funding in the initial phases, for those startups which actually raise venture capital in the initial phases, those startups have to look for 10x, 20x scale in the next years. Why? Because the investors themselves ask the founders that you utilize the cash, you burn incredible amount of money, but you scale rapidly. But for a startup which is bootstrapped, these startups can actually scale up their company by being profitable at the same time. And that can only be done if you guys scale up to an extent of 5x max. But if you guys actually focus on scaling your company 10x or 20x, eventually you guys will lose money and run out of cash in the next few months to come. These were some of the very powerful business insights that I got from Adil Qadri's journey, Adil Qadri's business case study. If you guys know and if you guys are aware of any other business insights, any other business analysis that you guys would like to share with all of us, with all of our business community, I would request you guys to comment down below so that your insights can be valuable for all of us, for all of our business students who are interested in building incredible startups, incredible brands in the near future. If you guys like this business case study, please hit the like button, please hit the subscribe button as well and hit the bell icon so that you guys can get regular notifications of all of our business case studies. This case study was brought to you by the B School, your online business school. I'll see you guys in another case study very soon. Till then, stay tuned. Take care. Bye-bye.